Measurement Units, Section 1, Converting Multidimensional Units, or Rates. While you may never have heard the phrase multidimensional units, you probably see them every day. Rates is defined as two measurements needed to describe something. Here, we may see product pricing as rates, money per unit, could be gallons per foot. It may be something to do with reference to our employment, pay, is dollars per hour generally, or perhaps as a productivity rate, frames per hour. Properties of metal, if we're talking about density of something, sometimes it's expressed as pounds per, could be cubic inch or per foot. Here's examples specifically. Steel has a density of 0.283 pounds per cubic inch. An I-beam has a standard of 3 pounds per foot. These are all describing rates. Sometimes it's useful to be able to convert such units. In this first example, we have the cost of some stock steel at $32.67 per foot, and we're asked to convert that into an equivalent price per inch. We will start with the rate, which is money or price per length. Take what is given. Money will replace with the specifics from this example per one, just like the step that we used for converting single dimensional units. We will put it as per one, expressing it as a fraction foot. Next, we want to convert this into money. That's already taken care of, but instead of foot, we want it per inch. So our task this time for this particular problem is to replace feet with an equivalent inch. In our conversion factor, we will want to put the foot this time in the numerator so that it cancels out the unit in the denominator. 1 foot is equivalent to 12 inches, expressing this conversion factor fraction so that we accomplish the canceling out of feet. We put the 1 foot in the numerator, which cancels out the foot or feet measurement, leaving us with money in the numerator per inch in the denominator. Simplifying now with the multiplication of the fraction, we multiply the numerators and the denominators. Then, to simplify further, divide the numerator, 3267, by the denominator value of 12 to give us an equivalent $2.72 per inch. As an application to this, the question asks, if a small project requires 30 inches of this flat stock, how much does it cost? Now we can take our price per inch rate that we just found, multiply it by the number of inches or length of stock that's being purchased to find the cost for this project. In this next example, we're given something that costs $4.25 per gallon and asked to convert it to an equivalent price per liter. Here, our rate that we have is in price per quantity. The original problem is giving us a $4.25 per 1 gallon, the implied one. Having that one there helps us with setting up our fraction. We want to convert money per 1 gallon into money, which doesn't need any conversion, per liter, which is where the conversion comes into play. So we're going to set up our conversion factor fraction so that the current gallons in the denominator is canceled out. So looking up gallons and liters, we find 1 gallon is equivalent to 3.79 liters. If we express those two equivalent values in a fraction, their overall value is 1, so we're multiplying by 1 to give us an equivalent value that we're looking for. Canceling out common factors, the gallons are gone, leaving us with money per liter. Multiplying numerators and denominators and the division results in $1.12 per liter, an equivalent rate for this item. This next example, we have price per 3 feet, and the question is asking us what is an equivalent price per inch. So if we look at the generic rate, we're talking about price per unit of length. The specifics will replace money, $15.51 in the price. Length, we're given per 3 feet, so here we will put the 3 feet. The goal is to get this converted into an equivalent price, which is already taken care of, per inch. That's where the problem is. We need to convert our foot measurement into inches. So our conversion factor will be set up so that the foot factor is in the numerator with the inch factor in the denominator. Here we have equivalent factors over one another. This is a fraction ultimately equal to 1. Multiplying by this special 1 allows us to cancel out the feet factors. Multiplying numerators, we have 1551 over denominators. Here we have a 3 times 12, resulting in 36. And to simplify this, we'll take the numerator, 1551 divided by 36, gives us the price per inch. As an application, a question is being asked, if a small project requires 105 inches of this steel rod stock, how much does it cost? We now have our pricing rate per inch. So we'll take that 43 cents per inch times the length of the requirement, resulting in a price with inches canceling out, leaving just money, a cost of $45.15. Here's another example where an invoice from a hospital indicates that a doctor's fee is $2,780 for surgery that lasted 1 3/4 hours. A rate question is, what is the pay per minute for this physician? So we have a pay per, that's our fraction representation, translates into generically money, that would be the pay, per minute is generically represented with the term time. We are given that the invoice amount or the pay received to this surgeon was $2,780. The time that the surgery lasted in a decimal representation is 1.75 hours. And the problem is asking is not price per hour, but price or pay per minute. Our money is all right, but we need to replace our hours with minutes. So in our conversion, we will set up our conversion factor fraction so that hour representation is in the numerator. 1 hour is equivalent to 60 minutes. So there's our relationship set up. Next, we can cancel out common factors and simplify the fraction multiplication. Simplifying further, taking the numerator divided by the denominator, results in a price of, or a pay of, $26.48 per minute. Final example here, we have 12 gauge shotgun shell has an advertised muzzle velocity of 1,250 feet per second. Most of us don't have a frame of reference in feet per second. We're more familiar with miles per hour. So to have some sense of how fast this muzzle velocity is, they're asking us to change feet per second into miles per hour. We'll set up our rate as miles generically is describing a distance per unit of time. Hours is a specific example of time. Putting in the information from the problem, the distance traveled is 1,250 feet per 1 second. So here's our given information expressed as a fraction with a denominator of 1, the implied 1 second. We want to get this converted into miles per hour. Here in this problem, we have two conversions to take care of. We want to replace feet with miles. That's our first step, and the relationship between miles and feet is given. The feet will go in the denominator with the 1 mile in the numerator. The feet is going to cancel out. So we now have miles per second. And before we grab the calculator, we'll set up the entire conversion. The next thing is we need to take care of seconds. We've got our numerator covered. We have our miles, but it needs to be per hour. So to replace seconds, we can set up our next conversion factor that gets rid of seconds in the denominator, which means when we put our conversion factor fraction here, we'll have to put seconds in the numerator and our minute factor and equivalents in the denominator. Seconds are gone. Last, we now have miles per minute. We need to get rid of the minutes and replace it with, finally, hours. So 60 minutes per 1 hour. Units that aren't canceled out in the numerator are mile. The unit remaining in the denominator is hour. So we have miles per hour. That's what we're looking for. Our last step is to multiply the numerator values, 1,250 times 60 times 60. Multiply the denominator values together to result in the following. Taking the numerator divided by the denominator value gives us an equivalent of 852.3 miles per hour. For additional practice, look at page 10 in your textbook.